Un hangar noyé au milieu des entrepôts d'un faubourg de San Francisco, c'est là que le Creedence Clearwater Revival se retrouve chaque jour. Garage et salle de répétition, mais aussi salle de jeu, salon de lecture, ce hangar est un univers complet où le groupe s'isole avec sa musique.
I guess we're right in, you know, we're rock and roll. We're not, you know, psychedelic over on this side, and we're not that easy listening thing like Glen Campbell or something. You know, we're right. We play rock music. It's we try not to be, you know, that ultra polished professional playing in the nightclub. We don't like that at all. But we don't want to be the you know, the dirty hippie thing. I'm saying that as a joke because it's kind of silly, but we don't really want to appeal, let's say, to that thing either, because our music, the music is much more important than what we look like or even what we think, you know. It's the whole thing is all for the music, really. We've been together for a long time, about 10 and a half years, so we've played a lot of different kinds of music. As rock and roll progressed, we sort of went along with it.
And what's your name?
What does that mean? Well, mostly we picked it because it sounded good. You know, we'd been together all this time and nothing was happening with the group, so we decided we wanted to have a little revival among ourselves. And that's what that part meant. It just, let's get back to the basics, you know, let's get back to where we were 10 years ago, you know, when we were much more honest. We weren't trying to be commercial or gimmicks or anything like that. We were just trying to play music. Now we come down here every day, rehearse, talk about music or what's happening, you know, with other groups or other records. Plan the future a little bit. And at night, usually I'm home. I watch television or I read a little bit. And it's maybe not exciting to someone else, but it's very exciting to me.
I'll try, Jake.
To me, the nightlife, nightclubs, lights, big city, all that sort of thing, is very dull, very uninspiring, not interesting, because that to me that's a sad way of life. It's like, since you have nothing going of your own, you have to go out and find stimulus to make your life exciting, and to me that's very sad.
That's worse than cold turkey. Whoops. Rotten the mic. Cut that. Do we have artistic control?
We did go through a stage of buying things, material things, right after, I guess, around the time Proud Mary was a hit here in this country. And it didn't take us very long to find out that the money really, it's very fleeting type thing. In other words, you can buy a new TV set or a new Rolls Royce, but you can't really live in them. You can't ride around in your brand new car all day and tell yourself, my, this is just wonderful life here. I mean, you have to, sometime you have to get out of the car and walk around in the world, you know. And I just came to the conclusion that why waste my time wanting those things? I guess our outlook is very middle class, really. We're able to make it by each month. We're able to pay for, if we bought a pair of shoes or something. So from that point on, it's just, you still have to exist in the world. You still have to get along with your friends. You know, you still have to try to grow in your outlook. Let's say mature in the way you see the world. And money doesn't help you do that at all. So we've forgotten it.